Friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this question, we have been given this circuit and we have been asked to find the output voltage. Now if you look this circuit, then here the op-amp is configured in the transimpedance amplifier. That means this circuit converts the photocurrent into the voltage. So as the light which is incident on this photodiode increases, then the output voltage will also increase. So basically, it converts the current into the voltage. Now in this circuit, through the photodiode, the reverse saturation current will flow from the cathode to the anode. That means the reverse saturation current will flow in the downwards direction. Let's say this current is equal to the IPH. Now here, let's say the current which is flowing through this 10 kilo ohm resistor is equal to I1. So if we apply the KCL at this node, then we can say that this photocurrent IPH is equal to I1. And because of the virtual ground, the voltage at this node will be equal to 0 volt. That means we can say that this photocurrent IPH is equal to V0 minus 0 divided by 10 kilo ohm, right? That means Vout is equal to IPH times 10 kilo ohm. Now here we have been given that initially, this reverse saturation current is equal to 100 microampere. Let's say at that time, the voltage is equal to VO1. So this voltage VO1 will be equal to 100 microampere times 10 kilo ohm. That is equal to 1 volt. And when the light falls on this photodiode, then this current increases to 200 microampere. So let's say at that time, the output voltage is equal to VO2. So this voltage VO2 will be equal to 200 microampere times 10 kilo ohm. That is equal to 2 volt. That means when the light falls on this photodiode, then the output voltage will increase from 1 volt to the 2 volt. That means we can say that for the given question, C is the correct answer.